Learn how to get started in ArcGIS Pro by creating projects and editing. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel for another tutorial. The first of a series of tutorials dedicated to ArcGIS Pro. Before we continue, please take a moment to subscribe below if you haven't done so already. So today we'll be creating a project in ArcGIS Pro and connect our file and multi-user geodatabase, as well as get started with some quick editing. In my last video, I mentioned that when we create a new project in ArcGIS Pro, an associated geodatabase and data folder is also created, and you would have to map your existing data folders or geodatabase each time. So let's go. So we launch ArcGIS Pro and we create a blank project with a name of choice. Upon creation, you see the associated folders and the new empty geodatabase. Now we will add an existing file geodatabase. Usually we need to add maps, layouts, or scenes in order to see data or edit. Similar to how you create a new empty map in ArcMap, this is pretty much the equivalent of that, a new blank map. Remember also in my last video, I said that you can import existing MXD files or layouts. I will remind you how to do that quickly. So we go to the Insert tab and we insert existing MXD files as maps or layouts. Anyhow, we also need to attach an existing multi-user geodatabase. So we go back to Database and select New Database Connection. Here you need to select your database platform. I'm working with a workgroup geodatabase, so I select SQL Server. Even though we know that the database platform for a workgroup geodatabase is usually SQL Express. So we actually need to ensure that the instance name is entered correctly here. And in my case, I need to ensure that it ends with SQL Express. I typically use the OS authentication type, so I select that here. And I also select the database that I want to connect to. So one thing I probably should have added in the last video is that we don't add database servers in Pro. We add connections only. You can comment below if you've noticed otherwise. So whereas in ArcMap or in ArcCatalog rather, we can add database servers, we don't do that here, only the connections. Now that we've added all of our existing connections and we've added our data, we can start editing. So if you haven't noticed yet, ArcGIS Pro has kind of a Microsoft Office vibe going on here. So there's technically only one toolbar, and this is our standard toolbar, which has everything including an edit tab. And this is where we go to start editing. So no more editor toolbars. Here we can create new features or modify existing features. Today we'll be creating new features and I will modify the attributes of these features. Upon creating these features, I intentionally didn't edit the attributes so that I could edit them later, and you'll see why. Once you select Create, then you can select your feature template from the list of features available to be edited. And everything comes up here. It doesn't matter if it's from multiple geodatabases or from multiple data folders. It will all still show here. So in my scenario, I collected a bunch of utility poles with the steel feature and they all carry the same attribute. So what I do here is that I digitize all my poles first and then I modify the attributes for all the poles at the same time. There are multiple ways of achieving what I did here, but this here is just one example. You can copy and paste attributes as you edit your feature. I'll also edit a line and polygon. So today we created a new project, we attached existing geodatabases and folders, and we got started with some editing. In the next tutorial, it will be a quick one where I'll edit with the trace tool and use the direction and distance feature and a few more stuff. As usual, thank you so much for watching, and please don't forget to like, subscribe and share this tutorial with a friend or colleague who you believe would benefit from this information. Also, leave a comment down below to let me know how you like the tutorials or if you have other tutorials that you would like to see. Thanks again and see you next time.